Imagine you're going about your normal workday when suddenly your boss tells you they'll be observing you for the day. Instantly, you start sitting up straighter and working faster than usual. Now that you know someone's watching, you're conscious of every move you make. This is something that can happen in research too. It's called the Hawthorne effect, or otherwise known as the observer effect. When people know they're being monitored, they tend to act differently and sometimes more in line with what they think the observer wants to see. Now, how does this concept relate to UX? The Hawthorne effect can impact user research by causing participants to alter their behavior when they know they're being observed. Users might try harder and exert more effort, or they could be more mindful of their actions than they normally would. And all of this can significantly distort your data because it doesn't reflect their real-world behavior. In this video, I'll go over 5 general guidelines you can use to reduce the impact of the Hawthorne effect. Depending on what UX method you're using, not every tip will apply in every situation, but you can adapt these general guidelines to your specific research study. Number 1, create a judgment-free setting. Help participants feel comfortable being their true selves. In usability testing, remind participants that the product is being tested, not them, and that they should behave how they naturally would, because we want to understand natural behavior. This takes the pressure off, so they won't feel the need to try harder or pretend they know more than they do. In field studies, remind participants you're there to observe, not evaluate. Number 2, ensure confidentiality. When participants feel confident that their responses or actions won't be linked to them personally or shared outside your team, they're less likely to alter their behavior. In surveys, and especially those with sensitive questions, include a clear statement like, "Your responses will remain confidential and will only be used for research purposes." In usability testing, let participants know that any recordings, if applicable, will only be viewed by the team for analysis purposes and will not be shared with anyone else. Number 3, use realistic tasks. Create tasks that reflect what users would actually do in real life. If you're running a usability test for an e-commerce site, you could ask them to find a birthday gift for a friend, which is something they might really do. Avoid unrealistic tasks like count how many images are on a site. That feels forced and doesn't reflect natural behavior. When tasks feel authentic, participants are more likely to get into a natural flow, making them less conscious of the fact that they're being observed. Number 4. Minimize the observer's influence. Limit visible or direct interactions to help participants feel less under observation. In field studies, maintain a low profile, standing back and letting participants go about their usual routines. In moderated usability testing, stay fairly quiet after giving them instructions to prevent participants from seeking approval or second-guessing themselves. Number 5. Build trust and rapport to help participants feel more at ease. Connecting with participants can start as early as a pre-study communication phase. Use warm and respectful language in your screening questions and communications, ensuring participants feel treated with care and professionalism. Show empathy for participant needs by checking in on their preferences and any accommodations they may need for participating. Also, trust can develop gradually over time. For contextual inquiries, consider running longer sessions or conducting multiple sessions with the same participants so they can feel more comfortable to open up as the study progresses. By considering these 5 guidelines, you can minimize the Hawthorne effect and gather more genuine findings. In the end, you can use these more accurate and authentic insights to create a better experience for users.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.